I want to talk to you right now about a fundamental threat to American democracy. It is a crisis of confidence.
The 70s. An angry era. Inflation. Vietnam. Watergate. Iran. Demonstrations and riots. The ripoff. The scam. The hustle. The cheat.
In the 70s, there is fear. Fear of crime in the streets. Violent crimes are up 130% in the last 10 years. Murder up 62%. Rape 116%.
In the 1970s, the phenomenon of serial murder was brand new and absolutely frightening.
Motiveless, random killings, sometimes thousands of miles apart.
But at the time, the term serial killer didn't exist.
Charles Manson and three girl members of his so-called family were found guilty of murder in the first degree.
For the murders of actress Sharon Tate and eight others.
The fact that somebody could murder and murder and murder.
In New York, the search continues for the Son of Sam. In the past year, the killer has killed five people and wounded four.
And could get away with it for a long time and be undetected.
13 young women were murdered over a period of 6 months, their bodies dumped in hilly areas of Los Angeles.
In the so-called Hillside Strangler murders.
It really unnerved people.
Police today found six more bodies under the John Gacy house.
Gacy admitted killing the young men after having sex with them.
You see bodies in your sleep, you see him in your sleep. It's just too much.
But nobody unnerved them more than did Ted.
It's a mysterious former law student with a charming ear in court. Bundy is on the FBI's top 10 most wanted list, being sought for questioning in 36 slangs.
Ted stands out because he was quite an enigma. Clean cut, good looking, articulate, very intelligent. Just a handsome young, mild mannered law student.
Yes, I intend to complete my legal education and become a lawyer and be a damn good lawyer. And I have a great model over here, so I think things are going to work out. That's about all I can say.
He didn't look like anybody's notion of somebody who would tear apart young girls.